Okay, that's all I got.
Oh yeah, that's not even close.
Damn it.
Hey animals, you found DNews, I'm Trace. This video was everywhere recently showing a dragonfish opening its jaws by 120 degrees, meaning they can, horrifyingly, swallow their prey whole. The gorgeous video is from a new study in PLOS ONE looking at the evolution of the heads of this family of deep sea fish. The dragonfish has sharp teeth, not for chewing, but for holding. The idea is to get the food into the stomach whole. Yikes. There's not a lot of food where it lives, so this is a huge advantage, but the ability to swallow food whole isn't unique to these fish. In terms of jaw opening, snakes put the dragonfish to shame, with jaws opening to 150 degrees. 180 is a straight line. The goal here is to, of course, swallow their food whole, which just sounds uncomfortable. Why would an animal evolve to not chew? Swallowing food whole evolved because, to be honest, chewing is hard work. It takes energy. Most mammals chew, though not all. Dolphins swallow their food whole. Reptiles, on the other hand, seem to like only taking one bite. This is because chewing expends energy. A 2013 study, also in PLOS ONE, postulates that a major advantage for swallowing food whole is, quote, no time needed for processing. Animals that swallow their food whole get the energy from their food ASAP with minimal energy tax. The PLOS ONE researchers think not chewing is what helped some dinosaurs grow so large. In a study done with a python, 37% of all the energy in food was spent just digesting it in the first place. So many animals swallow their food whole simply to get the energy as quickly as possible. Circumventing this energy tax did help humans evolve too. Ancient humans had large faces with bigger chew muscles. A 2016 Nature study found as we evolved tools, we began slicing or grinding our food before eating, and that decreased chewing 13%. More energy for doing other things, like thinking. So the dragonfish doesn't chew, likely because it's quicker to let the teeth grab and the fish swallow to get things started. It costs less energy. But we had trouble finding a lot of information on exactly how the dragonfish's digestion works. Luckily, we have some analogs on land that we can look at. The snake, for example. Snakes swallow their food whole, and they have a special enzyme in their saliva to start the digestive process as they walk their jaws over the food to pull it into their stomach. Snake venom actually contains cytotoxins, which are also to aid digestion. They start the process from inside the prey. On top of that, once in the stomach, the snake has to digest everything, pretty much. They have specialized cells shaped like golf tees that help break down the hard bits, even bones and eggshells, depending on the species of snake. Because a giant bulge in the middle of one's body is evolutionarily disadvantageous, digestion happens pretty quickly for snakes. Estimates range from a couple of days to several weeks. So, back to the dragonfish. It has this crazy jaw in part because it needs to swallow food before the food can escape. Plus, it doesn't need to chew because that costs energy. If the prey is large, the dragonfish can expand its stomach, not unlike a snake, but commonly they'll eat smaller things like shrimp, plankton, other fish, or they'll get aggressive and snag an occasional cephalopod. Hopefully someday we'll know more about this intriguing species, but for now, at least, we have this crazy jaw to look at. Evolution is an incredible thing, creating a whole tapestry of different forms of life. But this one animal or plant, or which is it? Well, it might be both. Watch this video to see how something could be both plant and animal. What's the most food that you've ever eaten in one bite? I actually can eat a hot dog with condiments and a bun all at once, although chewing isn't pretty. Let us know down in the comments. Make sure you subscribe for more DNews, and thanks for watching.